And we're now into the commentary for the Lyoko, the new Abridged series, episode 6. And basically, well, let's just give it a minute and let's watch the one good part of this episode. No, this is not it. Here it is, right here. Now, for this theme song here that you're hearing, I don't know where I got this from. I just found it somewhere online on YouTube, and then I just downloaded the video. And it actually only until this episode and episode 7 where they use that theme. Now, as you can see from that explosion, we are continuing where we left off in 5. We are continuing where 5 had left off. Basically, showing us that explosion was basically showing us what happens if we didn't stop Xana's attack in time with the nuclear power plant. And so, yeah, this is continuing it. Finally, I'm ready to review. Oh my god, Org is talking. Oh my god, Org is talking for the first freaking time. Oh my god.
Ah, the Italian one. Yumi, the bitch slutty one, who happens to be my soon-to-be future chick wife, and I'm gonna fuck plow.
Okay, I may have maybe I kind of a little rambled on a little bit too much here. Don't see it. I could have just shortened it. My leader, the virtual chick. But yeah, yep, as you guys just saw right there, this is the first episode where Orc talks. Yeah. But originally, this episode was supposed to explain why the hell Orc wasn't talking through the first 5 episodes. Not until I did. Oh, there's that Steve Oko impression from Herb that I did back in the prequel episode. But yeah, this episode was originally meant to explain why Orc wasn't able to talk through the first 5 episodes, but I did a poor job, so this is when we got the revamped episode.
Stop touching your bloody ass.
Okay, so I'm just gonna warn you all right now. You may want to not listen to this part right here.
Shut up, you dumb cunt.
Because honestly, it's a little uncalled for. Okay, then it's over. Now, right here, obviously, I just asked Oleg on why is he able to talk now. And now, supposedly, according to Oric, we're going to use the same exact footage from Garage Kids like we did back in episode, back in the prequel episode, where we did that whole backstory time bullshit. Originally, this was supposed to explain why Oric was able to talk through subtitles at the beginning, and why... And not talk at all, but obviously it was a total epic fail because it didn't really explain much at all. So this is where we got the episode one's revamped episode to explain why Oric was talking and why did he start talking through subtitles. It's on my channel right now, so if you want to go check it out, you can go check it out. And I believe this is the last episode and the last time you will all see any footage from Garage Kids in the Abridged series. I believe this is the last time. And you guys are probably noticing I am not talking. You guys have probably noticed I haven't said anything about the I haven't said anything about the, the music for this, because obviously you all know what it is. It's got, it's the Blue Oyster Godzilla. But anyway, yeah. Like I said, six is supposed to, episode six actually takes us off, continuing where we left off from episode five, basically showing us that Xanadu actually didn't launch the attack on the nuclear power plant. Or maybe he did. Or maybe he most likely didn't. Who knows? But obviously, that's the whole case, technically. That's technically the whole case. Episode 6 is mainly to continuing where we left off in episode 5. Basically, because episode 5 ended off with a cliffhanger with Xana destroying the nuclear power plant and whatnot. But here in episode 6, it's finally revealed that he doesn't do it for some odd reason. Oh boy. This is where we get the most cringy, outrageous, this is where we get the most cringiest old rated jokes ever. Starting in this episode and onward, Jeremy gets involved with the sexual inappropriate shit, basically. I don't like you that way. The first time, it's with Sissy. And, this is the first time this happens to him. Okay, I have to literally say this, but why the hell would they keep toxic chemicals in a fucking school basement? That's not safe. That's insane. Like, why would you keep it? Why would you keep toxic chemicals in a fucking school basement building? Yeah, that assures you that's safe. Well,
okay. Back to what we were doing.
Well, obviously, that's about it.
Okay, good.
That's about it for my impression of Herb. That's about it for Herb, me voicing Herb as Steve Urkel from Family Matters.
How about we sing it together at the same time?
Because obviously, starting at... Because obviously, for the rest of the show, we don't see Herb at all. I mean, we only see him as a background character, but that's about it. Nobody else voice. He doesn't get any voice screening time or anything, or any of that bullshit. Oh god. I forgot about this. This is the second time where I came up with this stupid joke idea where Jeremy and I need to come up with songs and we have to listen to the full songs for about until they end. Until I feel like cutting it off. This was a fucking idea. This was a fucking stupid idea that I came up with. But yeah. Anyways. As I stated already. Okay, so anyways. If you guys have not getting it from episode 5. Episode 5 actually starts us off with the very first story arc to my Abridged series. So 5, 6, which is the one we're on now, and then 7, which is the conclusion. It concludes up the first story. 7 concludes the first story arc. But this was like the stupidest story arc for the first time I tried to come up with. And then later, the next time I came up with a story arc would be in episode 12, where William gets involved in this show, and then my friend Ashton James comes involved, voices him, and both he and Yumi plot to kill Auric for at least 12 and 13. I don't want to spoil it too much until we get to those two episodes, but The story arc idea for the story for those two episodes was pretty good. Okay. I believe we're about to come to part of the story arc, because Xana is now sending out the smoke to attack all the victims and tell either and basically kill them. And then basically killing them.
I don't want to have to go deal with...
Now, this was the most stupid... Now, right here, this was the most stupidest plot ever. But generally, this was the most stupidest plot ever, because what happened here was... Well... Let's just watch.
So I'm going to need you to listen to me for what I say, okay? The first thing you're going to need to do is that you're going to travel 26 episodes for postseason. That means you'll have to travel 26 episodes past season one.
This plot that Aelita is going to be telling Jeremy what to do is technically stupid. It's really dumb. It really is.
Go to the core, Lyoko, and then take the transport.
That's all I can just say right now.
Whatever it is to travel. So you must go to season four so you can go to season four.
I had no idea what was I thinking back at the time when I was doing this episode in particular.
Then come back from season two, then come back here to season one to destroy the smoke, and that would be it for the mission, Jeremy. That's the only request if you want to stop the smoke.
Whoa. Hang on a second. So, you're telling me that I have to take the transporter in season three to leave here from season one, right? Then I have to go...
Okay, so basically what Aelita is telling Jeremy to do is that he has to cross all three seasons to get to season four. And basically collect William's sword that he got when he was under Xana's control, which that doesn't make any sense, because knowing the fact that Jeremy didn't even fucking know about that yet.
I gotta come back here to season one to take care of this, destroy the smoke. That is so bullshit, right there.
Okay, so basically, how would Jeremy even know about William having that sword that Xana gave him, knowing the fact that he didn't even fucking know about William yet, nor William joining the group and being under Xana's control? Or William knowing about doing that idea of possessing him?
Message and mission to do. I'm afraid I can't help you anymore, Jeremy. I'm going to die.
Obviously, this was the most... Obviously, this was the most dumbest plot that I came up with.
Shit, I guess I gotta do this all my own now.
And... You are just about done. For episode 6. Honestly... Yep, it says... Yep, right there. It says to be continued. So basically, this is, this is continuing our next story arc. This is continuing the story arc into episode 7, I should say. So, looking out. So, yeah. When we get to episode 7, this first story arc will officially conclude. And why you shall continue this commentary in episode 7.